techniques, Facebook, Twitter. You ready?
Yeah.
Yeah?
Sure.
Good morning, everyone. My name is Oliver, and I come from Estonia. And I will tell you a little bit about technology, how it has changed the way tourism has consumed today, and also how it has changed the way we as tourism businesses or tourism promoters, marketers should also use these modern tools. I would like to start with just getting to know who you are. So how many of you run some tourism business, private business? Right, it's about 20%. How many of you are from some universities who are lecturers, or let's say educators in some other school? How many of you are students? A few students. And how many of you are working in some destination marketing or management organization in some? Okay, so I hope my slides will be there, so I can...
Just 2 minutes, we changed the systems from Mac to PC, so...
And now I can continue asking some questions. How many of you are from Poland? Polish people, please raise your hand. Oh yeah, it's half or even more. How many of you are from Estonia? And what other countries? Sweden? Ireland, 3 people at least. Lithuania, oh, 5 people. Very good. Latvia, 1 at least. Very good. And Russia, no one here. Belarus, somebody from Belarus. Ukraine,
Netherlands.
Netherlands, 2, 3.
Turkey.
Yeah, please. Where are you from?
Turkey.
England. Turkey, yes. Sorry, Turkey. Two Englishmen. One Turkey. Cyprus. I know there is one at least. So what are the countries that I have forget about? Yeah, Norway. Sure. Italy.
How many dogs?
Yeah, it's just to introduce, I will not tell very much about technology. It's more about people and communication and sharing stories, word of mouth, like the oldest way of communication. And how these new ways of communicating, how they actually do the same thing. So it's not about tech. I do not, I cannot fix technology myself. I am not the IT specialist. I never was interested about actually how things are working. How can you stream this video? But it is enough that it does a stream. Video. So, And I need also this thing you. On this picture, you see a bridge. It is an old railway bridge from Warsaw to St. Petersburg. And we are paddling here with my friend Ivis, Ula River, which is in Lithuania, in Dzūkija National Park. Near this park is also an old railway station. Comes from that time, 1860s, when this connection from Warsaw to St. Petersburg was created. And I have to say that Lithuania is one of my favorite destinations for myself. To visit and learn about the national parks. I come from one of the national parks of Estonia, and I am not going to promote it here during this presentation, but a lot of photos that are illustrating what I'm saying are from Soma. Soma Park is a huge area of bogs, rice bogs or peat bogs. And one of the five national parks in our country. So the technology is the topic of our next hour. And if you have smartphones, I have not. It is just a very old model because my smartphone is here used to something else. I use this one for calling and smartphone for the other things that I'm going to tell now. And you can switch them on. Not off, but switch them on, and you can, whatever social network, social media you are, you can use a hashtag #Eureka15 and share what you hear here, or what are your thoughts. So, what is the hashtag? It is a kind of way to filter the huge amount of content, the messages that come to these channels, and it is a way to find people you want to talk to and you want to become friends or your potential customers, other partners. And here are just a few examples from that I picked from yesterday. And I asked Markus, in the end of very end of this slide, you see that I asked him if he is following our live stream. And everybody is presenting his nice company, Wild Sweden. And he immediately replied that no, he is tracking some wildlife. But it does not mean that he does not carry his smartphone in the wild Sweden and using it like real time. So this is like a behavior of the, not of tomorrow, but it is behavior of today. And I already told a little bit about myself, but I wear different hats, so I raised my hand when the businesses was raising hand. Also, I do some lecturing at the university and I do a study there, nature tourism. And here you see some of the photos. So, something that is unique in the area where I come from is floods, and the local people call it for five seasons, so the flood is being the fifth of the seasons, side of four normal seasons. And this place is also known as Estonian Amazon. So if the foliage is really high, you can also take a canoe and paddle in the forest. So one more exercise for you. If you think about digital and social media and technology, can we do a little check how many of you feel that you are like you don't know nothing about it and you are digitally illiterate? Nobody. So how many of you think that you are like a five-star digital users? Nobody. So we are something there in between. And I hope that on my talk you will get something to take with you, some like ideas or something, reasons why to upgrade your literacy. And here are the things that I would like to tell. It's a little bit about why, what's the reason, also like about the word of mouth and storytelling, old concepts that are now living a different life, or it's a different way to think about what the storytelling is. And also I will give at the end some tips about the social media platforms and ways to use it. If you have questions, you can actually raise your hand and we can take them. Yeah, in meanwhile, when I'm talking, because I have these PowerPoint slides, and it's no problem for me if you come with questions immediately. Also, those who are watching the live stream, you can tweet, use please hashtag Eureka15, and I hope some of people who here who use Twitter, like Mary, Anna, Jeppe, Chris, you can see if there are some questions. At the end, I can also answer for these questions. So, the slides went a little bit away, but these are a few images that describe the reason why should we, why we are talking about it. So, technology is everywhere. It has been changing our lives. And I remember when I started my business, it was 20 years ago, I bought 5 canoes. And I wrote the press release to a few local medias, newspapers, magazines, and sent it by normal mail, by post. And I asked them to come and join a fam trip on the rivers of Soma, and they could see what I'm doing and what are my ideas. And it was okay. There was 6 people coming, so my first customers in a Communicative was journalist. And how they replied me was by the same way, by post. They sent me an answer that, okay, I come these dates. The other way was just an old fashioned phone, which was in our kitchen. And of course, if there was nobody at home and nobody was in the kitchen, then we didn't know that there is somebody calling. After a few years, I got something that was attached to my belt here. I think the English term is pager. And the thing is that you can receive things like SMS. You cannot send it from here, but you call, if you want to send it, you call the operator and you say, okay, please send this message to this number. So it was like a phone, some number as a number. And yeah, later came phones. My first phone was something like number 2 in the row. And now we have Wi-Fi everywhere. We use mobile phones and tablets, and there are like Google Watch and Google Glasses, and things are coming, and everything gets smart. Yeah, there are already smart toilets in Japan, and a refrigerator. We'll see what you put there, and if it is not good for your health, we'll tell you that you should not eat it, and so on. So technology is changing everything, and of course it changes also how we travel. So here are 5 stages. I come back to these stages later. It is You can see that in this circle, the tourist's journey, there are steps, and in some concepts there are 6 or 7 steps, but this is how Google sees the cycle of travel. And the first thing is dreaming about. We dream about some place, we want to go somewhere, and what was the old way of getting these ideas? Was magazines and books, films. Of course, these magazines still exist, but nowadays many people get the idea to go some place from web, from internet. And next is then planning. We had guidebooks. The guidebooks are still here, but we use more and more things like TripAdvisor. Booking. I don't remember when I went to the travel agent's shop. I do it always now by using computer or booking directly, booking.com and other websites. And when we experience, when we are also using the phones, tablets to share what we are experiencing with our networks, with our friends and other who follow us in these media. So sharing is something that is throughout this journey now in every of these moments, but this I am going to tell a little bit more detailed in the next slides. So here is one slide from TripAdvisor. I will not go to all these figures, but these figures show how this the usage of mobile phones, tablets and similar tools is growing, and how people are getting more and more used to this technology. So, those of you who like acronyms, there is something that you can take with you. FOBO means fear of being offline. And there are not only this, but there is really many problems also connected to this behavior change that you use too much smartphone instead of communicating with your friends in an offline way. Often the use of mobiles, the use of Twitter, Facebook, it is called mobile revolution. Also in a direct way, like in, we all know Arab Spring and what was the role of mobile phones and social media there in communicating. And day before yesterday when I came here, I met my friend from North Cyprus, the occupied territory by Turks. And it was election there like a couple of days before, and they ran the campaign for some new president who is now very much looking for peace and using also Facebook and Twitter very much. That's what Errol told me. So one of the recent studies about adventure travel, which is for me not very much different from eco travel. This is collected by Adventure Travel Association, and the data, and it says that between 2010 to 2013, the percentage of adventure travelers who are using Facebook has increased more than 2 times. So the reason for this is very simple. People are using it, our customers are using it, and it is very logical, very pragmatic to fish where the fish are. So even my mother is in a Facebook. This is what we was talking this morning, like, how are you? And we do it every morning. Like, what's the weather there? What's the weather in Poland? Oh, it's really warm in Poland. And things like this. So it is not that she is a techie. She wants to keep in touch with the sun. So people have always talked about what they experience. They like to share their experiences. And we know it as a word of mouth, as a most powerful way to market whatever you have to market. So This is from Hugh McLeod. So it is some saying that I picked getting to the point. So it is not created, it's co-created, and it is a kind of virus. It spreads like a virus. So what we should do is use this knowledge of how word of mouth is working. And there are three reasons for people talk about you. One worst reason is yourself. So they either love you or your stuff, your product, your experiences, or they hate it. So both are reasons to talk about it. And the important thing is that you make it easy to talk about it. Other reason is that they like to talk about themselves, being in this place, having this ecotourism experience right now, sharing it. And they want to feel that they are very important or very smart, fashionable, whatever it is. And it could be also that they want to help other travelers. So the reason to share what they have experienced can be helpful for people who want to come there to the same place. And also that they, like if you think about Maslow, that they feel this is about them, they want to express themselves. And then also it is a feeling of us, we as a group, and part of the family, part of people that belong to this ecotourism crowd, part of the community. So social media, it is not a trend. Do you agree? It is a new way of word of mouth. It is an old thing, just using this modern technology that is here anyway. And I could add also a picture here with some Stone Age or Bronze Age people. And you can call their collections social network also. So social networking is not a technological thing. It is just a networking between people. It has always been existing. There are reasons. I believe you do not see it very well, but it's a list of why people use social media, so I will quickly read. First, to stay in touch with what friends are doing, to stay up to date with news and current events, to fill up the spare time. This is often criticized that I have no time, or yeah, the tools who are there, they are just wasting their time. So also share their opinion, share photos and videos to meet new people and some other stuff. You will have these slides, actually they are uploaded already to slideshare.net, so you can read and go also to the Global Web Index where this data comes. So telling stories is something that is a most underrated skill, says Gary Vaynerchuk. Raise please hands who knows who Gary Vaynerchuk is. Have heard about it? Not many people. He is born in Belarus. So you could check it up or Google this guy. You will find very easy to understand videos, and he's now one of the most famous social media ambassador in US, consulting also big companies, but actually started from scratch selling wine and campfire or Twitter. There is no big difference. There is some difference, but not a lot. So, in order to sell ecotourism better, the storytelling is a way to do it. And the story is about the place where you are. So what is the unique things in your area, or what are the things that people are sharing after being there? And it's not only that you should tell these stories, but you should also think about the other people who share these stories and find out who they are. So it could be your staff members. It could be some people from your village or from your town. Of course, your customers. And not mentioning media. Nowadays, blogging and travel blogging is very important to do. To go this way. So, as a tourist marketer, a business, or a DMO, a destination marketer, the role is not only to promote and create content, but find out what is said and curate it. So, meaning listening, reading, finding, filtering it, adding to your own content, and sharing it. What do you think, why are the stories that your customers share more important than the stories that you share?
His objective.
Yes, sir. Who believes if I am saying that Soma is so great, that Vlad and is so wonderful, natural phenomenon, and it is so nice to come and paddle canoe in a flooded forest? Do you believe?
No.
But if your friends are saying it, or somebody else, then it is more trustworthy. So the way to think, see it is not just the stories, but also the stories that are shareable and give it to your customers and I like the word ambassadors. Some figures, so 41% of UK consumers write reviews after they about their trips. It's not only after they are home, but also during the trip. So it is something that people like to do, sharing what they liked. So sharing is caring. It's a nice saying. And 24% do it via social media while they are on holiday. Half of them wait until they are back at home. So a little bit more details. Do I have a time? To these five stages, and you see that this sharing, it's not a separate fifth step, but it is throughout the four steps. Experiencing, first dreaming or inspiration, then planning the trip, booking, buying, and then travel itself or experience itself. All this way people do share what they find, or they ask for help from others who share their experience. So there are a lot of studies done all the time. One of them says that more than half of Facebook users have been inspired to book, to go someplace, because they have seen their friend's pictures on Facebook. So they want to do the same thing. They want to go to the same holiday, to the same national park, or whatever the place is. Oops. So it's called the wisdom of friends. We believe what our friends are saying. Next step, planning. So this figure might be already higher. It is a couple of years ago when Google did this study, so 85% use internet as a main source for planning the travel. And some more figures, 60% of leisure travelers watch online video on YouTube, now also on Vine and other coming video platforms. when they need to decide about the destination, and 55% when they want to decide which hotel, which guest house to stay. So video format is something that comes very quickly and is getting more important. Yeah, booking, so it's like I already said, and like I think most of you know, it's a very easy way to book things. And then yeah, over 50% use mobile phones when they search for, it's about experiences. So over 50% of travelers use mobile phone or device for travel-related information. Some more figures about reviewing, and I will not read them for you. You can read it yourself. It says the same thing. And if I would have another hour, we could go into the details of all these platforms. I had not heard about these two that you mentioned. These like new fancy platforms or tools. But it is changing. So of course there are some bigger major things. We already have mentioned them. TripAdvisor for tourism, Facebook, Twitter, YouTube. But it's actually the learning experience. And one of the crucial points is you use the same platforms, same channels where your customers are, and which fits to you. But I have some examples about some of them. Pinterest. Pinterest is one very quickly growing network. It's about sharing photos, and through photos also sharing links, so kind of bookmarking way of using web. And the reason here is that often reading long texts are not as easy for people than looking at the picture. So the picture is something that tells a short story in a very good way. If you use smartphones, then platform is Instagram. It's also using hashtags, these keywords that people attach to the messages, so it's a very similar logic there as using Twitter, which is sending a short text. So here you attach hashtags to your photos, and this way you see who are the people that share the same interest, but also as a marketer you can use it and find your niche, your audience, and talk to them. And if a photo tells 1,000 words, then video, does it tell 1,000 times more than one photo? I'm not sure, but anyway, the video is something that is growing very quickly, and the young generation, they use things like Vine, and there are some other very much shooting short videos and expressing themselves more and more, not only to photos, but also to short videos. So, how it should be from you as a business or a marketer? It should be not just selling and promoting, and more things that people look for, like something useful. Something maybe educational or something fun, something that entertains them. And of course information, because when they are in the process of this travel, especially the research and booking process, they need information. They need to know where to find the things that they are looking for. Social media is not just for sharing stories, but it's also for communication between you and your customers. So you can get a lot of feedback there, and you can learn a lot about your customers, about your audience, using social media. So why should we listen in social media? What our customers are saying? Why should we listen at all what our customers are saying? It is the same like a question. Of course we need to listen to them in order to know what they like and
Free consulting. It is free consulting for us. We don't need to pay for it.
It is of course also free consulting, and your most valuable customers are your unhappy customers. It is also said that they are the people that you can learn the most and improve your offer, the quality of your products and services. So even if you don't, you are afraid, what should I say there or what should I post there, I have no clue. By creating a konto, you have access to this listening tool. So you can, if you're not there, you don't know what is said there about you, about your business, about your place. If you are there, you don't need to publish, to post. And it is even wrong to start with just posting, publishing, but take your time and listen what is told there. You are using hashtags and other keywords, and there are search on Twitter, search on YouTube, on Vine, all these things. And my favorite is this one. It's also open in my computer here, and it allows me to follow different hashtags about different discussions, like now Euroeco 15, but also like Tasting Europe, which is one food tourism program, and there are many other. It depends on what you do, who you are, what is your profile, and what are your interests. Would you like to see what the media writes about you, or customers, or some European funders? It can be different. And there are a lot of such things. So if you search, and you can of course consult somebody. I do not use this, but I just put the mention as something that exists, and I use it for connected to my email account. So if something is said with a Soma, it comes to my email, and I can look it. So I will see that who was posting and using the word Soma. It's of course easier for Estonians because our place names are unique, and there is only one person with my name plus family name. It's getting more complicated if you are in a bigger country. Yeah. Join these conversations. It was also said by Chris that there are groups online that where the people who share the same passion as you, where they talk about things. So here is one example of biggest group in Facebook. It's not called ecotourism, it's called responsible travel. For me, it is a synonym. And I know that Depe is there, Anna and Mary maybe, but it is really lively there. And you get a lot of connections also, not just information, but connecting to people there. So there are many such groups and communities, depending again, maybe your own language groups, Polish or Estonian language groups. So you should join them and be part of it. Another example of the group that runs weekly chat on Twitter. Every week they have like a new specific topic, and it is lead by media people, travel bloggers, travel journalists, but of course you as a DMO or a student or a business or NGO, you are also welcome to join. And of course, you can also through social media find your potential buyers and partners. This example here is from Facebook and my own experience posting about canoeing there in the summer. And one friend who also is friend of Anna hooked this and came to visit. And he used to be also a freelance writer, so one of the places she writes is a National Geographic Traveler. She wouldn't know anything about this without me sharing it on Facebook. And you can also do a lot of collaboration. So here is a call from Ron Mother. He is running a website, planeta.com. This is the first, the oldest website about ecotourism, celebrating now 20 years. And part of it is a social website, like wiki format, but and also different, he used a lot of different other platforms like for photos, Flickr. So he invites us, it is from yesterday, to send photos about our places. And it is from his slide. The Ecotourism Europe is a popular group on Flickr. It features already 600 plus photos and graphics from 50 members, including local tourism professionals and visitors. So you are all invited. Just join Flickr and post your photos, and your place, your small place, will be there. From St. Guy, invitation to become a volunteering writing, editing his website. So as this website is running in a wiki, who of you have ever used Wikipedia? Who have not, never used Wikipedia? You are just tired. I will finish soon. Of course you know Wikipedia, but have you ever thought that you can all edit Wikipedia? It is open for everybody. The same way this website is run on a wiki platform, so it is collaboratively edited the website. And here is, tomorrow morning I took this screenshot, what is there about Poland now. And any of you who are Polish, who are experts about Poland, you can come and join it and write it. And of course it is not a place where you put your ad. Not this way, but yeah, information, something interesting, something that wakes people's curiosity about Poland. And yeah, facts, so info. So if there is some message, it is here. I mean, how you could act is join some of this, start listening there, connecting to other people that you want to connect, be helpful, engage, and everybody can share. Everybody are welcome to share their stuff, their experiences. It's time for questions.
Yes, thank you, Ivar. Time for questions and answers. We had some discussion about communication at the end of Chris' presentation, but we can continue now.
Krzysiek, Ivar, wspominałeś o... Krzysiek, wspominałeś, Ivar, o plecaku platform społecznościowych. Ja kiedy tutaj przyjeżdżałem, byłem bardzo ciekawy twojego wykładu, bo jestem na bieżąco z mediami społecznościowymi, ale obserwując zalew tych platform, które powstają, zastanawiam się, jak w nich nie utonąć, jak wybierać te, które są najistotniejsze z twojego punktu widzenia. I pośrednio dałeś mi w tej chwili prostą odpowiedź, być tam, gdzie są nasi klienci na tych platformach. Natomiast cały czas zastanawiam się nad odpowiedzią na pytanie, jak nie utonąć nadal w gąszczu tych informacji, jak nie, przepraszam za określenie, zwariować w tym świecie wirtualnym, pomimo tego, że jest to świat wirtualny, on jednak wcześniej przenika się z tym naszym światem rzeczywistym, realnym. On jest strasznie pochłaniający nasz czas. I jak ty sobie dajesz z tym radę? Może powiesz nam, ludziom, którzy też z tych mediów korzystają, aby rzeczywiście nie oderwać się od tej realnej rzeczywistości, a jednocześnie być w tym drugim wirtualnym świecie.
Yeah, the question was about, actually, was actually two questions about this. There are so many tools, you know, this virtual rucksack or digital rucksack. How to choose one that are for you? And I also answered this, and so that it is the rule is that be there where your customers are, or yeah, customers. Also in maybe indirect way, where your potential partners are, or funders, or where are the people that you want to communicate. So it is not different from which seminar should I attend. Should I come to Jahkanka or not? Should I go to next meeting, which is in Warsaw next week or not? It's like, who come there and what is discussed there? And also, your other part of the question is about how not to draw on all this huge load of information. And part of it is related to the first, but also using these keywords, hashtags, it is now very like a smart way, if you're already there in a Flickr or in a Instagram Twitter, and through these you can filter. So it works like a filter. So TweetDeck that I use, it has like loads of tweets, but then through these you will filter the information that you see. Or you can also filter to these people. Like there are some people that you want to follow, like everything what they write. There are some in this audience that I follow like this. So and actually there was a third part about the real world and virtual world. And here I do not understand the question. It is not different world. It is the same world. These are the same real people. This is just the way to talk, to have conversations. There is no virtual reality. I mean, you should not go there and put the name like something else. You should be there with your own face, with your own name, and be yourself. So it's the kind of misunderstanding that often I hear, now less and less, that people are talking about virtuality, if they are talking about these things. Do you get what I mean? Because we are just in the different parties in that sense, but my belief is, or my understanding is that this is a real world, what we are discussing, what I was presenting. This is a new way to having the campfires or discussions around campfire, and also it relates actually to what we discussed at the end of Chris' presentation, how to do it. Yeah, we have no resources, no time, no money to meet, and it is the best way to go to a study trip. I like to go to Lithuania, as I already mentioned, to see the national parks there. And I would like to come back to see Vigri and Bierža, and these two are very similar to our reality, so I would like to come there and meet the businesses there and see how they work with German market and things like this. But I cannot do it too often, and we cannot do too many ecotourism meetings. So if this is available and we want to do something together, it's just to start using it. I mean, just doing it, not discussing it, but join, listen, share. Thanks for question.
Ivor, just one of the comments I would make to maybe explain to people how important to Google and to people finding them up all the new social media are, that they really, really help your rankings, and the importance of Twitter for media in particular.
Yeah. Yeah, I didn't touch search engine optimization, and Chris mentioned this term. And of course, the first place where we normally go, if we want to have some information about whatever it is, also about places to travel or places to stay, or local guides, or some where I can ride a horse or where I can hire a bike. It is that we type hiring bike in Yakhanka. It's typical, and Google gives the answers. But this is the little bit other thing, other part of running your website and optimizing your website to the keywords that your ideal customer, your the people that you would like to get, what they might type when they look for the things that you are, what you want to offer them. And it's just. I mean, I could tell about this now 5 minutes, but
it's nearly essential.
Yes, but it is also very important part of your website and your presence online to think about to be easy to find. And if you use social media, then it becomes quite natural. You don't need to be thinking all the time about optimizing. But if you share your stories, you write about the things using the word, of course, then the language of the person who searched for this. So I only use two languages, Estonian and English. All my online life is in two languages. I speak very good Russian, but I never write anything in Russian. But I might do it because Russians maybe are. Could come, but I mean, it is you cannot do everything, so there is a choice. And English is often the language that also people who come from Japan or Germany, even they find English content. What I've been putting there. And the other thing was how important is Twitter for media, and I can only agree. This is the only actually social network where I have my conversations and connections about media people. Of course, other thing is offline, just to personal contacts. When you go to some travel fairs like WTM in London or ITB, and then you meet these people. And for our case, it's also really important to have a good relationship with a tourism organization, Estonian Tourist Board. And through them, we got journalists visiting us. But then, of course, I follow these journalists. So after we have done a trip, it was one of that kind of trips last week, we got five journalist from British Guild of Travel Writers coming to Estonia for 4 days or so. Half day they spent there, I was guiding them 2 hours, and I followed three of them the same evening, shared my own few photos and retweeting their tweets, and this is the way it works. So now when they publish something, they will of course share that they have published in the magazine or newspaper, they will share the Twitter. I mean, if journalists are already using Twitter, and most of them do, then everything what they do is shared in a Twitter.
Hello, Ivan.
Hello.
Thank you for the presentation.
Yes.
Maybe you could tell us how many people or how often people who you don't really know but they contact with you by social media eventually find your place and visit your place.
Mm.
Thank you.
I don't have a figure because I am generally I am not very much into statistics. And my business partner, who is Alvis, who was in a, on the first slide, he likes figures and he likes to have an eye on all these things, like how much we have money and how much we have customers this month, this week compared to the year before and 2 years before. And so we always discuss this kind of things like a team, and then I get a much better idea. I know that data is very important, but it is my weak part, having a good picture about all this statistics and data. But it happens times to times, and I would think it happens quite often that people that I no, and then they come and visit, but also that they find information from there. So maybe we are not connected yet, but after that they join our page on Facebook, or we will get in contact. So in Twitter, I do not, I am not connected on Twitter with my customers who come and use our service, canoeing and guiding. It's more like for journalists, for ecotourism people, for researchers, because part of my life is university, and for customers who come to our park, the main platform is Facebook. So we also run paid ads on Facebook, but if there is a trip next weekend, then we pay for Facebook for showing it to a certain segment, and Facebook is really great for this because you can really what it is, a target to certain persons. And the way I do is it, people who already like our Facebook page, who are 5,000 people, and they are friends. So it is like also this wisdom of friends, that because you can also pay more and they will show it for everyone, but oh yeah, everyone in the world, it will cost you a lot, but everyone in Estonia, still it will cost you much more. So both in Google, you can do very good work by buying ads, and also on Facebook now, not now, but already many years, but I started to use it now. So paying some fees and controlling this, how much you use and for what keywords in case of Google, and for what segments, what people you show your ad on Facebook. It was not really the answer. Huh? Or, you happy? Thank you.
Dobrze, to myślę, że dziękujemy bardzo. Chyba, że ktoś jeszcze chciałby coś dodać. I think we thank you, Ivar.
Yes.
Yes. Thank you so very much for your time. Zapraszam wszystkich teraz na kawę. Spotykamy się o godzinie 12:30. There'll be a coffee break. We'll meet again here at 12:30. So please come on time.
Sorry.
Jeszcze one moment, please. Jeszcze chwileczkę. Przepraszam.
Sorry, I did forget there is also a last slide. Where will be the next ecotourism conference? Is a question for you when you go to lunch.
Yes, this is the question. Thank you, Ivan. To teraz przerwa. Proszę Państwa, kilka informacji organizacyjnych. Myślę, że głównie dla gości z Polski. Kilka osób poinformowało, że chciałoby dzisiaj wyjechać. Jeżeli Państwo mogą zwolnić pokoje w trakcie przerwy obiadowej, to proszę to zgłosić do recepcji. Jeśli ktoś dzisiaj skraca pobyt, nie zostaje do jutra, to ogromna prośba, żeby zwolnić to i prośba też do osób, które miały słuchawki i wczoraj nie oddały, zgłoszenie tego do stolika ze słuchawkami do Państwa.
Пожалуйста.
Can you copy the address? Is it some card with your website or?